こんな野郎シナリオにあったか。
さあ、
Hey there, nerds. Fino here with a servant guide for the Damigami herself, Rider Ishtar. She's a 4-star quick arts hybrid and a welfare servant coming up in summer, too. I'm writing this before skill names are confirmed, so those might change on release. With that in mind, let's take a closer look. Skill 1 is Glittering Aquatic Gown. This is a party-wide quick and buster buff that comes with an NP gain modifier. It's a bit odd in that she only has one buster card, but otherwise perfectly fine. Skill the second is Excel Turn. It's a clutch crit amp and single hit evade. The crit modifier is huge, 50%. On the other hand, the evade kinda sucks. It's only good against NPs, and a few enemies actually throw shit at you before doing that. Another point of note is that Excel Turn has a very generous 4-turn cooldown to compensate for its short-lived buffs. Skill 3 is Summer Breaker. It gives a whole bunch of single-turn buffs, the most important of which is invulnerability. However, it comes with a delayed self-stun, which is kinda rough. That said, the buffs cap out at 50% across the board, so that's pretty interesting. It's flexible, and the crit amp in particular lets you go all in for huge damage turns. If you card count and know that you won't draw any Ishtar cards next turn, you can pop this for no practical drawback. Good stuff. Ishtar's Noble Phantasm is 7 colors. It's an AoE quick attack that comes with a preemptive quick buff and overcharge. Simple but solid. On top of this potent kit, Ishtar has Riding EX and Independent Action A for large passive quick and crit buffs. With all these toys in hand, let's cook up some teams. I know you're as tired of hearing it as I am of saying it, but the end-all be-all for quick attackers is Scotty. On top of the usual massive damage and looping potential, Scotty amplifies Ishtar's crit damage while Ishtar herself has NP gain modifiers to make the process smoother all around. A very strong, if predictable, combo. Conveniently, Ishtar has a fair bit of synergy with Summer Raikou, with the latter providing a party-wide attack and Star Gen buff, and a targeted cleanse that comes with a buster buff. The nice thing about this combo is that Raikou herself is a powerful crit character. That means that after a Star Gen turn, you can commit to either Ishtar or Raikou, depending on who has the better cards. If it's Ishtar, you can pop all her buffs and cleanse off her delayed stun. If it's Raikou, you can pop her absorption skill and go to town. Pretty much the only losing scenario is if your third member takes up all the real estate. Speaking of which, I recommend Infamous Hand Eater Waver as he provides both attack and crit buffs for a well-rounded package. His charging effect gives you a fast start, and with 20-30, he provides a degree of consistency. One of Ishtar's weaknesses is that she has no absorption skill, but you've got a few ways of getting around this. The first is to run Berserkers, whose low absorption makes the issue moot. Star-generating ones like Lancelot and Raikou are ideal for this purpose, since you'll have resources for Ishtar to play with. And like with the Summer Raikou case, these servants can take the stars themselves if your hand requires it. The other solution to Ishtar's absorption woes is to get it from another source. One servant stands out for this purpose, Ruler Ketz. She has a targeted absorption buff that comes with a Star Gen modifier. She also has a party-wide attack buff with passive star income, and like the previous servants, she can absorb the stars herself if needed. To top things off, her NP gives a party-wide crit buff, so in essence, she has a lot of things that Ishtar wants. To round out this team, consider a combo of Arash and Amadeus to keep costs low, easy mode wave 1, and dump 50 stars for a guaranteed big dick turn. As per usual, I recommend giving Amadeus Gudagooda Poster Girl to ensure he makes a graceful exit from your frontline. Babylonian Moped, Space Sheep, Marie's Weird Seizure Horse, these three have some weird-ass mounts, and coincidentally, they synergize. One of the cool things about running Ishtar and Marie together is that Guillotine Breaker works very well with Summer Breaker. The latter comes with a heal amp to benefit from Marie's heal, while the cleansing effect removes Ishtar's stun debuff. Guillotine Breaker also has a party-wide crit amp, which sets you up nicely for subsequent turns. The downside of this arrangement is that Guillotine Breaker needs to go off the same turn as Summer Breaker. This means that if you pull a nice Ishtar chain, you can't use it without stunning her. For a third member, consider Altera the Santa, who's coming this Christmas as a welfare servant. Her supportive tools complement a quick crit team, and if needed, she can step into the attacking role herself to snipe out invulnerable targets. She also has her own delayed self-stun, which pops after 3 turns. This means you have a lot of time to cleanse it off, and you can play Marie's turns around Ishtar without worrying about Altera. Before I move on, I want to point out that Caesar has reasonably good synergy with Ishtar Rider. He didn't really fit any of the teams I was building, but he's got a solid suite of buffs, and budget players should consider adding some Roma to their lives. Moving on to craft essences, quick effectiveness, crit damage, starting charge, and star absorption are what you want, and the following options have one or more of these properties. Entombra, Summertime Mistress, Dumplings Over Flowers, Imaginary Around, Knights of Marines, Conversation on the Hot Sands, Seal Designation Enforcer, Dangerous Beast, Castle of the Sun, and Wolves of Mibu fit under this umbrella. Outside of this set, consider Golden Sumo for its general attack buff, or Cute Orange Jet for stronger and more frequent NPs. Ishtar also appreciates 2030 supports for regular star income. Now let's return to Summer Breaker. Because the self-stun is on a delayed debuff, you can cleanse it off. One interesting way of doing this is with command codes. These aren't in the game yet, but this mechanic lets you add extra effects to your basic cards, and some of these are quite handy. There's White Vessel's command seal, which removes a debuff on attack. And there's also Hachiyo no Kagami, which gives a one-time stun immunity on attack. In short, you've got some future-proofing going on. Overall, Ishtar Rider is better than Santa Altar, and her compatibility with the command code mechanic and future welfare servants like Altera the Santa and Ruler Ketz means that she holds up relatively well into the Lost Belt era. She's a good investment, especially for a free servant, and I'd recommend her. You'll get plenty of mileage. That's all for now. Like if you like this video, sub for more, tell a friend, and stop on by Twitch this weekend for some FGO action. Till next time.